The Mobile Accessible Pedestrian Signal (MAPS) system, helping visually impaired pedestrians safely navigate signalized intersections. University of Minnesota, driven to discover. ITS Institute, University of Minnesota. A man walks a sidewalk, sweeping a cane over the ground ahead. Words read, more than 3.4 million Americans 40 years and older are legally blind or visually impaired. By 2030, the number of blind and visually impaired people is predicted to double. Complex intersections present safety challenges for everyone, especially blind and visually impaired pedestrians.
Imagine navigating busy intersections with little or no sight.
Traffic streams through an intersection.
Every day, visually impaired people use tools like white canes, guide dogs, and accessible pedestrian signals for guidance at crosswalks. Yet it's still not enough.
People interview.
Every day it's a new experience. I never know what I'm going to encounter exactly.
So I literally took a step out into the intersection to start walking and I heard a car screeching.
I have known people who have been hit and it's totally traumatizing for them.
A man works at a computer.
Researchers at the University of Minnesota are working on a groundbreaking and cost-effective system that will help revolutionize the way people with vision impairment navigate city streets. Senior systems engineer Chen-Fu Liao developed the Mobile Accessible Pedestrian Signal, or MAPS, to give intersection information to visually impaired users through a smartphone app.
We have very simple user interface. A single tab allows the users to point to a particular direction.
You are pointing to East Harvard Street.
It'll provide geometry information, street names, and how wide is the street it is to the users. And when they decide which direction they want to go, they can point it to that direction again and do a double tap, and that will submit the request to the signal controller, request for pedestrian crossing without pushing the mechanical push button. And at the same time, the system will provide a signal information to the users, telling them when is the time to cross.
I'm pretty good with direction, but occasionally I'll get a little disoriented and I'm not sure which direction I'm facing. Beyond that, telling me how far across I have to go. Because there are some intersections, if they've got an island in the middle and two lanes on either side of the island, sometimes I think I'm across the street when I hit that island. And I'm not, I'm in the middle.
The GPS system sure helps add an additional feeling of safety. And when you have that little additional thing that tells you, yes, indeed, the light is green, you have 20 seconds. That's just a nice reminder.
Liao collaborated with psychologists from the university's Human First program to conduct the research and gain insights. Additionally, he worked closely with vision impairment and mobility specialists, the Minneapolis VA Hospital, and Vision Loss Resources.
Well, engineer can design a great, fancy, fun stuff, but if nobody wants to use it, it's not useful at all. So the first phase of our study is to reach out to the community and ask them if we're going to provide this information through a smartphone device, what kind of interface will be useful to them.
Chen-Fu has done an incredible amount of research on the history of how blind people travel, traffic, transportation, the light systems, and put it all together to develop a holistic kind of a system. So I think the whole system and the whole concept is so beautiful. It just works well.
Ken Rogers, president of the American Council of the Blind of Minnesota.
My long-term vision is that the users will be able to use the system to go anywhere in the city or anywhere with cell phone coverage. So they'll be able to get the geometry information, signal information, and when they are taking the bus, knowing that this is the bus stop here and what bus is coming, and when they're getting off, they know which direction to go to cross street, to take transfer, things like that. Obviously, there's a long way to go, and we need to work closely with the public agencies and also the community.
Liao expects the MAP system to be widely available in the next few years, with the potential to reach millions of visually impaired Americans.
People walk with guide dogs.
MAPS is just one way the University of Minnesota is using research and innovation to increase safety and help improve our quality of life.
Funding for this research was provided by ITS Institute, sponsored by the U.S. Department of Transportation, and University of Minnesota. Web addresses, its.umn.edu and umn.edu. Copyright 2012.